One thing I've noticed about this code is it's a bit spaghettified.
What? You mean like it's falling into a black hole?
What?
Never mind. It's an astronomy thing.
It's spaghettified as in it's a mess of if statements and loops. Let's break this down into some more manageable chunks by using some functions.
Functions are awesome. Hey, have you read the book East of Eden by John Steinbeck?
This isn't a literature class.
I know, but stick with me. This is relevant. I was reading it the other day, and there was a passage that struck me. The story takes place around the turn of the century, and one of the characters, named Adam, gets a car. This was a big deal because cars were really new. Back then, you couldn't just stick a key in the ignition and get rolling. There was a long, intricate process of priming the ignition, getting oxygen into the engine, etc. The boys in the story had a mantra that they kept repeating to help themselves remember the process.
But all of this is automated now, right? Turn the key, start the car.
Right. You know, in the book, the characters had to pass instructions about the way engines work in order to start the car. Today, all of those instructions are bundled in the act of turning the key. Functions do basically the same thing. They bundle instructions together.
So if I had a start car function, it would abstract away all of the intricacies of starting a car?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, that was a decent example. Functions in JavaScript can be defined with two different syntaxes. The first should look pretty familiar if you've been paying attention. We start with var, followed by the function name, in this case, myfunc, equals, and then the keyword function, an optional parameter list, and then the body of the function. This keyword function tells the JavaScript engine that we're making a function.
And this is the second syntax. In this case, we actually don't have to start with var. We just start with this keyword function, and then we give our function a name, which in this case is still myfunc. Then, after myfunc, we have optional parameters inside parentheses, and then the body of the code goes between the two curly braces, just the same way we do with if statements and loops. These two syntaxes are pretty much equivalent. There are subtle differences in the way the JavaScript engine interprets these two different functions. However, they go beyond the scope of this course, so check the instructor's notes if you're interested in learning more.
Seems to me we should bundle the code we just used to populate the work experience inside the display work function.
Yeah, let's do that and see what happens. Here's a quiz for you. We want you to move all the code you just wrote to display the work into a function called display work. Make sure you put all of your code between the curly braces. But don't do anything else after you move your code into display work. What happens when you refresh the page? Pick one of these two answers. Do you see the same thing, or does nothing appear at all in the work section?